Phytase is a nutritional biotechnology that has application in animal nutrition as well as environmental implications. Phytase is an enzyme routinely added to commercial poultry and swine diets to break down phytate into a usable form of the mineral phosphorus. Generally speaking, 60 to 80% of phosphorus found in plant-based feedstuffs is in the form of phytate. Phytate is largely unavailable to be used by non-ruminant animals such as poultry and swine, as they have very little phytase activity in their digestive tracts. This is much less of a problem in ruminants, as phytase is produced by bacteria in the rumen, which is very efficient at degrading phytate into usable forms of phosphorus. Phosphorus is a required mineral that has many physiological roles included but not limited to maintenance of skeletal tissue, protein synthesis, efficiency of feed utilization, and fertility. Phosphorus is also the third most expensive component of poultry and swine diets behind energy and protein. Typically, manure from poultry and swine contains nitrogen and phosphorus in a 1-to-1 ratio. However, plants such as corn require nearly a 3-to-1 ratio of nitrogen and phosphorus for optimal growth. Thus, if manure is applied to fully satisfy the nitrogen needs of the plant, phosphorus will be over-applied. This results in an overabundance of soil phosphorus, which can cause eutrophication of surface water and eventually leaching into the groundwater. This can cause significant environmental concerns for livestock, wildlife, and human populations. Phytate not only decreases absorption of phosphorus, it also reduces the digestibility of other minerals, such as calcium, zinc, magnesium, sodium, and copper. Additionally, phytate is known to reduce amino acid digestibility by 3 to 16%, reduce dietary energy use by 8% in pigs, and reduce body weight gain and feed efficiency in broilers and pigs. The addition of phytase to poultry and swine diets improves the digestibility of many classes of nutrients. A subsequent effect of this supplementation is that it also reduces the amount of inorganic phosphorus that must be used. This allows for the replacement with other feedstuffs, which increases the overall nutritional quality of the diet formulation.
Historically, we've known about phytase as an enzyme since the late 1800s. It didn't become a commercial product until roughly the early 1990s. When they first developed it, inorganic phosphorus prices were fairly low, so that a phytase dosage essentially was equivalent to what the comparable phosphorus cost was in the diet for inorganic phosphorus. Roughly that was about 0.1% phosphorus. Since, to give you perspective of where phosphorus prices have changed since then, roughly in 2000, if we were looking at phosphate fertilizer prices, it was roughly about $200-$225 per ton. By 2012, that has increased to nearly $675 per ton. So we've really increased the amount of phosphorus cost over that period of time, and therefore phytase and its application has become much greater in use in animal diets. Roughly today in the U.S., if we look at swine and poultry diets, roughly about 95 to 99% of those diets contain some form of phytase. And a lot of companies are looking at increasing the amount of enzyme utilized in those diets.
The first commercially available forms of phytase were derived from intensely selected fungi. Currently, most are developed using recombinant DNA technology. In this process, a bacterial phytase gene is inserted into yeast for mass production of the enzyme.
Scientifically, over the years, we're probably looking at today roughly about a third generation of phytase being utilized versus what first came on the market in the early 1990s. today, that third generation of phytase is essentially a genetically inserted product, typically from an E. coli phytase gene, into a yeast for its production purposes. A lot of science has gone into production of that phytase, and today companies are looking at single amino acid modifications to improve the characteristics of those phytases, predominantly looking at heat tolerance so that that enzyme can be more thermostable as it goes through the feed manufacturing process, particularly through pelleting. Research with phytase has taken on a new generation. I mentioned earlier that companies now are looking at single amino acid mutations onto the phytase to make it have more interesting characteristics, to make it more thermostable, to increase the binding efficiency and efficiency to which that phosphorus is actually liberated from the phytate molecule. Some of the research that we're doing here at the university really has looked at how phytate, the substrate to which the enzyme actually works upon, negatively affects the digestive tract of the animal. And therefore, when we look at some of these new generation of phytases, they actually alleviate some of that anti-nutrient effect that some of that phytate molecule has on the animal itself.
Phytase is a nutritional biotechnology that is commonly added to swine and poultry diets. This enzyme breaks down phytate into a usable form of the mineral phosphorus. It is a required mineral for the animal, thus the addition of phytase enhances the ability of the animal to meet its phosphorus requirement, which is an expensive feed additive. Phytase also improves the digestibility of many other classes of nutrients. Additionally, the addition of phytase decreases the amount of phosphorus excreted by the animal, thus potentially decreases the environmental impact of excess phosphorus. This benefits livestock, wildlife, and human populations.
This presentation was a production of the Animal Science Department at Purdue University.